speaking with Dan Symons this morning from C3 Metals. Dan, good to see you.
Good to see you. Thanks for having me, Andrew.
A bit of recent news from you out of Jamaica, confirmation of epithermal and porphyry targets at Arthur's Seat. Just tell us firstly a little bit of background here on Arthur's Seat.
Absolutely. Arthur's Seat, that concession had very little modern day exploration, only in the very far northwest corner. Naranda, who was there mining bauxite back in the early 1960s, discovered high-grade copper in soil, geochem anomaly, as well as some samples. We went back to Arthur's Seat for the first time in record this past summer, and we've now identified an 8 kilometer by 4.5 kilometer area with over 100 high-grade copper samples, over a percent copper. And then within that, in the southeast corner, we have an outcropping epithermal vein and breccia swarm, which we sampled all up and down. It's 15 square kilometer area where we have multiple samples over 2 grams per ton. So what we've done is we quickly moved through the discovery, acquiring drill permits, and we've now put in our first scout holes ever into the vein system. We have the first 8 holes now have come back. And unfortunately, while we didn't hit the high-grade shoots that we would like to see in an epithermal system, epithermals are notoriously drill-intensive to find those high-grade shoots, we have confirmed these veins are live. We did hit 7.6 grams over 0.6 meters. We also, very key, have now confirmed both epithermal alteration as well as porphyry alteration in these drill holes. So when we overlay that with the magnetic anomaly, we can see we have clear porphyry targets at Arthur's Seat as well as the epithermal target. So good news moving forward.
And so what are the follow-up plans?
So the follow-up plans at Arthur's Seat, we're going to take a bit of time to do some statistical analysis on what would just come in through the drill core. We may decide to run some chargeability, some IP lines. We haven't decided yet, but we may decide to do that because where we're seeing visible coarse gold associated with bornite, which is a copper sulfide mineral, as well as pyrite, if the higher grade portions of the gold are associated with sulfide minerals, then the IP will pick that up. In the meantime, the next target where we'd like to go back to is at Bella's Gate, where you may remember last year, we drilled a few holes into multiple target porphyry targets at Bella's Gate. We hit near surface mineralization, our best hole being 15 meters downhole, 309 meters of 0.44 copper, 0.33 gold. And we've had shareholders be quite patient with us to get back and follow up on that because, and we're anxious to follow up on it as well, because we just don't have the drill rig on the island of Jamaica capable to test the depth and extent there. But, you know, we're in a situation where one 700 meter hole has potential to double the known tonnage. And now the good news is we've been in conversations with multiple drill contractors and we have line of sight on a drill rig now. So the goal is to be in and going back into known mineralization or grade mineralization, testing the depth extension and targeting those high grade bornite cores within these multiple porphyry targets we have.
Well, a busy couple of months ahead. Dan, good to catch up. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, Andrew.